Father, we bless you. We thank you already. Your presence and your power and your anointing is here. I ask for one thing, that people will experience miracles. Doors will open for them. The newness of this season, the newness of the anointing will begin to rise upon their lives. Father, we thank you because it's done. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. I appreciate the Holy Spirit as you sit. Have your seat. We'll just discuss briefly. Hallelujah. First of all, I want to honor the man of God, the resident pastor of this great house. Amen. Awesome, awesome man of God. I'm confident. You don't appreciate my pastor sitting down. Appreciate Pastor Patrick. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You can have your seat. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah. You know, there are the reasons why I can now disappear and appear. Amen. Because I know that, you know, there will be someone, you know, to be there for me and represent the grace of the ministry. I'm very glad to be here. Amen. I just came in today anyways. I know people thought I came in like earlier because I put up stuff on Facebook. But I came in today, this afternoon. And so I didn't have time to put a lot of stuff together. But I know that God will do something here today. I'm just here to bless you. This is the first time I'm ministering this year. Amen. I say I'm here to bless you. Listen, if you have not started experiencing new things, you are already late. But after tonight, new things will begin to happen. Have your seat. Have your seat. New things. New things. We are going to be, you know, seeing them. I told you before January 31st, you should be able to say, Father, I thank you. If the year will end in January, it's a great year. Amen. This January, we'll be talking about the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. I love what the pastor, spoke about. I want to share with us the key and the mystery of walking in the Spirit. Paul says something. He said, now that we are in the Spirit, let us walk in the Spirit. Meaning there's one thing to be in the Spirit. There's another thing to walk. To be in the Spirit is the assurance. To walk in the Spirit is the manifestation of that assurance. To be in the Spirit means you are prosperous. To walk in the Spirit means the prosperity flows out of you, through you. Many believers, all of us are in the Spirit, because the Bible says something, said, you are in the Spirit, if so be that the Spirit of God is in you. But you see, the Spirit of God doesn't just want to be there. He wants to manifest. He wants to produce results through you. He wants to show himself mighty. So many believers are in the Spirit. Being in the Spirit is not, let's be in the Spirit and everybody just put their hands together like this. You know, the way worship leaders will say, let's be in the Spirit. Where were you before? You know, you need to correct yourself as a worship leader. Why would you say that? Let's be in the Spirit. I hope the worship leader here doesn't say that. You know. I didn't hear. If you do say that, I've never heard you say that. Now, to be in the Spirit does not mean let's walk into the Spirit. Even to say, when we come into God's presence, where were you before? We are not coming into God's presence. We're already in the presence. But you are a carrier of the presence. Amen? But what God wants to do is that you walk in him, he walks in you. It becomes a corporation. You know, you cooperate with him. You manifest with him, you produce results. And the extent of God's manifestation through you is dependent on how much your body is yielded, how much your body is transformed. Because we need to really see the reasons why this man of God is manifesting power. This man of God, the grace and the glory of God is flowing through him, while this other one is not really flowing. It's something about flesh. Not that the power is not there, but the body is not yielded to the point that the life of Jesus in you will be made manifest in the mortal body, in the physical body. So that even at a point, even the clothes that you wear becomes the spirit, gets contaminated by what you carry on the inside. So whatever you now touch will prosper. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody, but many of us, we have businesses that are not prospering. It's simply because you've not allowed the life that is in you to take over your mortal body and begin to manifest. So that's why I said something here. I said, this is a big difference between being in the spirit and walking in the spirit. So on Sunday, we are going to be looking into that, because I know there are blessed men here. There are champions here. God wants to do something. See, it's not about too much talking. Amen? Anybody can talk. People can talk, especially in Cyprus. It's not about too much talking. It's about the power. The demonstration of the power of God. The kingdom of God is not in too many words, but in demonstration of power. Power becomes the language that we speak. If you've got it, demonstrate it. If you don't have it, you can't do it. You can only show what you have, but everybody can learn on how to speak. So we need to understand this. This season, God wants to demonstrate something through you. That even while you walk on the streets, things will happen. Yeah. While you are in your classrooms, things will happen. Because your bank account has got your name. And even demons know that name. Angels will know your name. And things will happen. A brother complained and said, I took exams and I got 5 over 30. 5 over 30, mathematics. I put the online mathematics 5/30. He said, man of God, I'm finished. I said, 5/30. No, no. Are you a dunce? I said to him, I said, let it be to you according to your faith. I said, something will change. After a while, he checked his portals. The 5 has gone to 16. He's on my stuff. He sent the portal. I actually posted that testimony with the picture, but I later removed it because I later found out that the courses has got the lecturers on them. If you put it, I know there are some very crazy people. They will go to the lecturer. I said, this guy got 5 and he turned to 16. Check. He said, go look into it. So I decided to remove the picture. I just posted the testimony so that people wouldn't know, you know, who to go to and what to go to. But you see, there are testimonies. They are too real. Yet people can doubt it. How is it possible? How can God do that? I tell you, there's nothing that is impossible. Everything is possible with God. Now, God wants to use you. Listen, when I studied the 12 disciples, including Judas Iscariot, I found out that God did not choose men that were qualified. He chose men. First of all, when he saw Peter, and after using Peter's boat, if you know the story, when Peter saw what happened, Peter said to him, he said, "Depart from me, for I am a sinner." He said, "Today I will make you the fisher of men." He said, "You used to fish, catch fishes. Now I will make you fishers." Peter, you know, Peter's focus was on his sins. Jesus' focus was on what he can do through this sinner. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. I want you to understand this. No matter where you are, God wants to take you up. God wants to use you. God wants to transform you. Now, if you look at, you know, Matthew, tax collector, all the stuff, he chose people that, you know, normally today, I said something to someone, I said, I listed 10 points why many believers wouldn't have believed Jesus' ministry today if he walked on earth. If Jesus was to come today, many of us that criticized the scribes and the Pharisees would have been part of them. Because of many things that we see today. First of all, you know, how do you deal with a lot of stuff that Jesus did? You can't phantom them. If you judge them, you will find yourself in a place where you say, "Jesus, I found you guilty." You know, first of all, why would he call Peter that said, "Clearly, I'm a sinner"? Today in the churches, the things of God should be for the perfect ones. If you have a comma, you should not be in church. You are not even accepted to be in church. But church is not meant for people that are already perfected. Church is for those that are struggling. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody here. Church is not for the perfect people. If you are coming to church to see perfected people in the flesh, then you've come into the wrong place. You better just die and go to heaven. Church is not, listen friends, we need to understand this. Even after Jesus taught the disciples, after 3 or 2.5 years of pure and core leadership from Jesus, they still denied him. They still ran from him. But did he abandon them? No. He still believed in them. He still stood by them. So he gave to some apostles, some prophets, some this, for the edification, for the building up. If you're already built up, why would you come to church? So these apostles are for them that needs building up. Because we are very quick to forget where we are coming from. I didn't arrive here today in one day. It took patience. There were people that looked at me and believed in me. Though I messed up many times, they believed in me. So I am here today now. I wouldn't give others the opportunity. Because church is not a place where you come. So when you come to church and you are busy looking at, oh, everybody has got to be perfect. Oh, everybody, you know, has got to do this. Everybody has got to dress in this way. Everybody has got to do this. Everybody has got to. You are in the wrong place. At least you are in the wrong place in a lighthouse. Our doors are no more open. And no wonder Jesus said something. He said, "Behold, look, even prostitutes are entering into the kingdom. You are busy judging, they're already entering there. They are going in before you." There's going to be a shift this season. The same people have talked down on are the same people that grace will come upon. So, we need to be many stuff. So, first of all, if Some folks were there when Jesus said, Peter, come. They will say, ah, this one doesn't know what he's doing. How can he call this sinner? Peter himself said, I am a sinner. Called tax collector, saw him collecting tax. You know, tax collectors of those days, they are the worst. Saw him say, hey, come with me. He left everything and followed him. If people saw that, he said, did you even know who is? Normally, they expected him to go into the synagogue and get all the scribes that can quote the Bible. Let me tell you the truth. You will not need grace if you are complete. Grace is for those that depend on the completeness of God. Acknowledging that they are nothing without God. We need to understand this so we can function. I used to say it, I say, I pray as if there is no grace. I depend on grace as if I have not prayed. That way, I come to minister fully insured in grace to function. Even Jesus was called the friend of tax collectors and sinners and wine bibber and stuff like that. He said, John the Baptist came neither eating nor drinking. They said he's mad. He's crazy. That's what Jesus said. But the Son of Man came eating and drinking. They said, what? He's a drunk. He said, but wisdom is known by his children. Amen. Meaning the end will justify. The same people that people look down on today will be the giants of tomorrow. Amen. If you believe that, say a better amen. Amen. I want to encourage everybody here. God wants to do something through you. Amen. Except your mind is not set on him. I always say something. If you are truly a believer, there is a desire in your heart to live right. Did you hear what I'm saying? If you're a believer here and the desire to live right has left you, you need reawakening. You've lost something. There's always be that desire in you. He said, corruption will be swallowed up by incorruption. Mortality will be swallowed up by immortality. I love what the pastor said here. He said, this low body will be consumed. Let me tell you the truth. There are some people that you see in the body. Their body is no more the same as your body. A man that can touch a sick person. And the Bible does not say pray for the sick. It says lay your hands on them. So you go to the sick person and say, hey, I command. No, you made a mistake. He said lay your hands on the sick. That means just one. Then the life of Christ will be transferred. It's real. The life of the Spirit. That time you just see the presence of God just flowing like a wind. Like a wind. Like a wind. When your eyes is metamorphosed into the spirit, when God shifts, you know. Because he sees it. You carry an atmosphere. He was saying something. You can't be consumed by the Spirit and grow old. Even when people look at you, they can see a glow. Someone look at me sometimes, say, this your eye is always piercing like this. I say, not in the way you know it. Not in the way you know it. I said, I'm here to bless you. Hey. Amen. Listen. When God says, I want to do something new, He wants to do something new. I spent these 12 days praying, visiting great men of God, just, you know, exchanging spirits so that I will be more kicked up. Met with great men of God. You see, seated here, 12 great generals. What you have seen me do so far, you will do more than that. 12 great generals. That's what I call them. Because I said it before, the truth of the matter is, if you're praying that I will be here always, you're wasting your time. Just be praying that I'll be coming often. Not that I'll be here. No. I was sharing with somebody 50-something invitations from 23 countries. So how can I do it? And they say, if you minister one place, sir, any day you minister, we give you $3,000. You minister for us for 5 days. If you are not in the spirit. So what did they talk for Cyprus? I beg, I they come. Oh my goodness. Let me tell you the truth, friends. I know many of us we want to be prosperous. Listen, before kingdom prosperity will flow to you in the way you really desire, God must first deal with your taste for money. It's now I realize why God would took years to deal with me on issue of finances. People invite you, call you, say, man of God, we have a conference, 2 days conference. Your honorarium will be $15,000. And you say to them, God is not telling me to go. Some, where do you talk? Where can I come? Let's come now and start prayer. 2 weeks prayer before the time. Oh God. Twelve persons here this year. Starting from February 1. Even when you don't want to manifest it, the manifestation will manifest you. God is saying, I will lift them up as giants. I told you I'm here to bless you. What I just mentioned now is just a preamble. On Sunday, don't miss the service. We are going to be talking on the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and we will have clear demonstration of the Spirit. Listen, many of you, as you are seated now, if you want, what is it that is possible or impossible in God's presence? Don't worry. On Sunday, we will see it. If I'm led, I want you to, probably I'll get mine.
our weighing machine, and some of all those things, just to speak to individuals. If you know your weight, just keep it. Sunday, but we want to go on a higher dimension. But I want to bless as God said I should bless. First, starting February 1, you will enter a dimension for your ministry. Even as you pray, instructions will come. For those that desire to prophesy, you say, Father, use me in this. God is saying, I will do it. Are you doubting what I'm saying? Stand up, everybody. Lift up your hands. Say, Holy Spirit, Father, have your way. In Jesus' name. Father, let that 12 persons receive a touch from you now, in the name of Jesus. Wherever they are, may your grace flow now to them, in Jesus' mighty name. Where are they? Let that grace go everywhere, everywhere, everywhere. Marase keko sheta. Nisheketa radea soteka. This is number one. Number two. The Lord said to me, he said, there will be buildings that will rise. People will be able to build houses. Now, that is, by the way, these ones, I'm raising them as financial giants. God is touching people. Oh. God is touching people. God is touching people right now. People's ministry will burst forth. And the Lord said to me, 23 of you, financial business plans, business connections will come to you. Now in the name of Jesus, I release it by the Spirit of God. It's coming on people already. It's coming on people already. People are receiving it by the Spirit. There's 23 financial giants in this room for the kingdom of God. Father, reach them right now, because finances is an anointing also. Father, release the anointing upon them. May they begin to receive it right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Eyes be opened. What you see is what you get. I love this. Jericho was under lock and key with big, big walls surrounding it. Yet, God said to Joshua, look, I have given you this city. He said, look, I have given you this city. Look, I have given it. Meaning, you need to look beyond the physical barrier and see something deeper. Friends, today, I command by the Spirit of God that eyes be opened here to begin to see greater and greater dimensions in the name of Jesus. There are 5 persons here that God is saying, I will open your eyes to begin to see into the future. You will prophesy as according as you are revealed to by the future. The Spirit that controls the future, the Holy Spirit, will come upon you. And your eyes will be able to link into prophesy and speak of what to come, as God will show you what is to come. Father, as I raise my hand, may that Spirit come upon them, 5 of them, in the name of Jesus. Wherever they are, from the front to the back, from the back to the front, may they receive it now, 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 now. Wherever they are, may that grace be released to them. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Moshe katra poche le fredouche prata proketusha tandre projetente roche kaprahate le no se. I am blessing everybody right now. Wherever it is, whatever it is that is of a burden, whatever it is that they desire to see results, Father, I cause heaven to open. I cause heaven to open. Can you get me my jacket, Pastor? I cause heaven to open. I cause heaven to open on your behalf. On your behalf. Any family issue. Thank you. Any family issue. Holy Spirit, I thank you. 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 Are you ready? The Lord said to me, say, pray for 50 persons because they are overdue for miracles. I don't know if it's in your family, your career, your academics, financially. He said they are overdue for a miracle. Father, whenever I call upon you, you answered. You have even answered even before I called. You said to me this evening, you said, go and bless them. And Father, I'm here to bless them. Now you said to me about 50 persons. And I know that your hand is not too short that you cannot touch. Hey, here is the Spirit of God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Lift up your voice and say, Father, may I be a candidate? Yeah, 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 yeah. Pray that prayer. Jesus, la kratash. Something is happening everywhere. Some of you are feeling the presence of God. As you are saying, Father, make me a candidate, the anointing will begin to drop on you. The power of God will begin to drop on you. As God will be touching 50 persons, prayers are being answered now. The anointing, the transformation that is needed for it will begin to rest upon you. Yeah, people are feeling the anointing right now. It's everywhere. Ne koshite breko parade kiso jela prato centro raketo sheke le prene konde si leka. Father, touch. I release your grace. Touch me, pass me not, O gentle Savior. Yeah. I just see Lord touching you. Hold her, hold her. Come on. Oh. Sorry. Do not pass me by. Somebody lift up your hands. Holy Spirit, I ask that 50 persons in this room be touched by your power, by your anointing, by your grace. You're not connecting with me, the person on the keyboard. Increase your volume. Please, everybody, lift up your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, some of you, your desire is in your ministry. Your desire is in your finances. Father, I am just praying now that you release that fire. They will not be able to stand it. wherever they are, it's happening. Wherever they are, even from the back, from my right to the left, everywhere, everywhere, the power, the fire of God, I release the blessings. I release the blessings right now in the name of Jesus. Put your hands on, hold my back so I don't fall. Thank you, Jesus. Please hold your neighbor. I want to close now. Sunday. In the next 7 days, this is for 7 people. If you are part of it, glory be to God. In the next 7 days, you will write me with an awesome testimony. Yay! Things are happening. Things are happening. Don't hold anybody on the hands. Just hold the neighbor, your neighbor. Don't guide anybody. Just hold your neighbor. Hold your neighbor by the hands. Hold, oh, I see the power of God. Hold, 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 wherever you are. Let there not be anybody that is not holding somebody. Hold somebody, hold somebody. Father, the grace that they have never seen before. Grace and the anointing that you have promised us. The newness of grace and glory. The newness of the anointing and power. The newness of blessings and lifting. The newness of life. The newness. Corruption will be swallowed up by incorruption. Mortality will be swallowed up by immortality. Disappointments will be swallowed up by appointments. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Something is happening here. Something is happening here. Something is happening here. Eko toko to rabata tata ta. Ripo seko teke 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 te. Receive it right now. Wherever you are, rapakito rata ya. For 50 persons right now, I command a change in your destiny. I command a change in your life. I command a change in your ministry. I command that your eyes be open. Every prophet in the house, I command that the prophetic be stirred up. I command that the gift be stirred up. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. May your eyes be open to the angelic. In the name of Jesus. It's everywhere. 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 The presence. The presence. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Receive it right now. Receive it right now. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. Karakata. Ekoto koto. I see the fire. I see the fire. Everywhere. 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 Massacre. Amongst them standing here, there are prophetic women here. They will stand in the office of a prophet and they will manifest what people will marvel at. Father, locate those prophetesses right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they are, I open it. I open it. The prophetic in them. Right now, in the name of Jesus, let their ears be open. The first step into the prophetic is in the hearing. May their ears be open in the hearing of the Spirit. That's a comfort. God will use you to do mighty things. What is believed? Disappointments are over. New lease of life you are receiving now. In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you, ladies. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Woo!
for you. Can you come?
God bless you. God bless you.